Hi, my name is Andrew and I'm a sculptor and wood turner from Australia. I have a workshop here at home and we live in a town called Madawi. It's about 2 hours north of Sydney. It's a modest workshop but has everything I need to create my art. I love to work with wood and I love to work with different forms, patterns and textures. My inspiration comes from everywhere, but it mostly comes from nature. Sometimes it comes from the most unexpected places and at the most unexpected times. The most annoying thing about this is that I get a lot of ideas right when I'm falling asleep. I've been using the Arbortech tools for a number of years and I find them to be well made and really useful for what I do. Next, I'll show you a few videos on how I use the Arbortech tools and the textures and carvings you can create with them. This first texture is created by keeping the mini furrow blade flat as it creates a smooth, curved cut in the wood. Here I am, just having a bit of a play to see what the tool can do. Experimenting is the best way to create different textures. Using the mini pro on its side will create a different texture. As you can see here, the mini pro is great for creating lines. Here I am using the blade flat again to create a slightly different texture. Here are just some of the textures and patterns you can create with the ball gouge. Thank you. Now I've switched to the turbo plane to see what different types of carving it can do. I usually practice my carving and texturing techniques on scrap bits of timber or plywood. Experiment on different types of timber to see which works best. You can create different textures and effects with the turbo plane just by using it in slightly different ways. Lastly, here is how I use the turbo plane to create a texture and a bowl. In this next video, you can see how all the carving and texturing techniques can come together to create a piece of art or sculpture. Using a combination of just a few tools in different ways can give you an endless amount of possibilities, only limited by your imagination. This is a slab of camphor laurel I purchased from a local timber dealer. Yeah. When I get an idea for an artwork, I usually create a small sketch. And to refine the idea further, I create many more small sketches. Once I've found one I like, I scan it into the computer and print it out at the needed size. Using a disc sander is a great way to refine the edges, and this will give me the final shape I need. Here you can see me using Forstner bits to create the hole in the shape. I'll then use a chisel to carve out the remaining pieces. Finally, I'll use a rotary tool and a carbide burr to smooth the edges. Here I am creating guidelines in the center of the piece so I can see how deep to carve. Next, I'll use the turbo plane to give shape to the form. I've now switched to a flap disc on my grinder to refine the shape further. This can be very dusty work. Finally, I'll use a sanding pad to finish off the sanding. I usually freehand the design to give the piece a more organic feel. Here I am changing to a different flap disc to use it on its side to create lines. For this next texture, I'm just using a sphere bit in a rotary tool. To remove all the fuzzy bits, I'm using a disc sander cleaner followed by some sandpaper. This next texture is created by using the Arbortech mini grinder with the mini pro blade on its side. After turning the piece over, I'm once again using the mini pro and laying it flat this time to create this texture. Finally, the last texture on this piece is created by using the mini pro on its side to make lines. So this is the final result after texturing. I sometimes leave it this way, but this time I have decided to give it some colour with some wood stain. I think by adding the colour it helps tie all the different elements together and makes the piece more cohesive. As you can see here, I decided to add another texture inside the existing texture. Here are some photos of the completed piece. Next up are a few other videos that will show you how I create textures on different forms.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
That's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed these videos and that maybe you learned something new. Thanks for watching.